For the longest time, I thought that my videos were getting less views because you guys could see my face, and I realized this past week that I had been not tagging keywords in the videos, so shame on me. Hi, this is Clutch, and today's topic will be insecurity. Now, before I get started, I wanted to thank the rest of you that have been reaching out. I know a number of you have been going through some quarantine matters at the moment, so understand that everything that you're going through right now is normal, and it's my hope that I can provide some closure or at the very least some comfort for the rest of you. Now then, insecurity, where does it come from? What does it mean, and how can we deal with it? A number of us will deal with insecurity whenever it comes to a breakup, and for the most part, when we're going through an insecure moment in our lives, we will tend to be really self-conscious about basic things such as our income, our well-being, our mental health, how we look physically, whether or not people like us. And all of a sudden, these insecurities tend to be very unattractive. But most importantly, it causes us a high level of anxiety. How do we get past this situation? Well, there's a number of things that you can do to get past the situation, such as this, especially when you're dealing with a post-breakup depression. But at the same time, I don't want to sort of spew solutions your way and just hope for the best, because getting over any breakup is also a question of time and persistence, and the idea of you just forgetting about someone instantly isn't realistic, unless of course you're dealing with someone who's incredibly dismissive, but I'm assuming most of you are not that. So let's talk about what we can do in a situation where we're feeling insecure. Let's say someone left us, and they left us in a really cruel and abrupt way. We're left questioning our own value system. How do we deal with this insecurity? The first thing you have to understand is the reason why you're feeling the emotions you're feeling at this given moment and why you're insecure in the first place. The idea of someone leaving us sparks a very unique trigger in most of us. And that trigger has to do with the idea of self-value. I've talked in the past about the notion of replication value and social value, which in all honesty tend to be pickup terms more than anything. But the idea is that when someone rejects us, they are essentially telling us that they do not deem us worthy of carrying genetic material to the next generation. Now, I know that's overly scientific and might come off as overly simplistic, but that is what it is. And the reason that you're feeling the way you feel has everything to do with your body's response mechanism in trying to get you to do the two primary things in life, which is of course survive and replicate. The idea of us being able to deal with a traumatic event, such as losing a loved one, is a normal and recurring event in our lives. At some point, you will lose someone you care about, whether it's through their own will, your will, or some kind of an external factor. And the reason that we feel pain, at least the reason most of us feel pain, has everything to do with our body and our brain's ability, or at least its attempt, to keep us safe. Because after all, if we're surrounded by those that we feel safe and comfortable with, the whole concept of insecurity doesn't matter. Insecurity is the body's way of telling us to realign with what our value system is. And in modern times, that might not necessarily be what the body wants, but of course, keep in mind that our prehistoric brain is severely outdated. What it's actually telling us is go find this person and try to be with them. This person is there to keep you safe. But the whole notion of a relationship is contradictory to what my benefits are, at least in the modern times. And the idea that we live in a society where we can have dozens of different spouses before we settle on someone that is more permanent has an unrealistic expectation, at least according to our 100,000-year-old brain. After all, the whole concept of human society, at least modern society, with technologies where I can talk to my phone, for example, and reach hundreds of you, if not thousands of you, has everything to do with changes in the times. And these changes, regardless of what they are, still haven't had an impact on our prehistoric brain. Our brain still wants affection. Our brain still needs security. But how can we get security when the very thing that gave us security rejected us? This is the notion of getting over a breakup and the idea of taking time to yourself. You have to essentially trick your brain into resetting that switch that is causing you this level of anxiety. But it's not an easy feat. I could tell you every single solution in the world, and none of those solutions will matter in the long term anyways, if I'm not doing the personal development goals that will allow me to regain that self-value. After all, the whole concept of insecurity is, again, to keep us safe. And if we're unable to feel safe by ourselves, how could we possibly feel safe with someone else? This brings up a bigger question, the whole question of codependency and the idea of being with someone for the right reasons. More often, we will try to bring people in for that sense of security, or maybe if we come from a dismissive side of things, we might try to reject those that come too close. What does that mean? Does it mean that we're flawed as individuals? Does it mean that every person is doomed to be single for the rest of their lives? Not necessarily, but what it does mean is that we have a lot to learn, more importantly about ourselves more than anyone else. We deal with insecurity in a moderate number of ways. We distract ourselves. We physically start going to the gym. We start doing activities that bring up certain dopamine triggers in our brain. But nothing can ever replace the notion of time, especially when it comes to the healing process. The idea of someone breaking a leg and jumping and doing a marathon the next day is unrealistic. And the same thing goes for a breakup. If you were to break up today, I don't expect you to go and date another 6 or 7 people tomorrow. And if you did, I would start questioning the very values that you're trying to preach. After all, we're human beings. We are allowed to connect, and we're allowed to be vulnerable. But in that vulnerability comes a chance, an opportunity, if you will, an opportunity to make ourselves much better than we once were before. It's very hard to see that this is what's actually going on, especially when we're dealing with the anxieties of life. The idea of being alone, the idea of not having a connection with someone that you once held close, is a big issue for most of us. In fact, most of you are here today because of a breakup of such a sort, where you've had to deal with that trauma and you've had to deal with that experience. But with that experience comes something very different. With that experience comes hope. With that experience comes rationality. And most importantly, with that experience comes security. And the next time that you are dealt something that attacks your insecurity, something that makes you question your value system, you can always look back and remember that through the dark times, you made it through. Thank you so much for watching my video, guys. As I've mentioned in the past video, I've now started coaching practices. I will list details about that in the link below. If you like this video, I will ask that you like, and if you love the video, I'd ask you subscribe. I'm trying to gain a following here. But with that being said, guys, this is Clutch signing off.